The first topic for today is Sociology of Coronavirus. So what is sociology in this epidemic disease? Discrimination, marginalization, alienation. This is what is the crux of sociology of epidemic disease, particularly coronavirus. Sociological studies were made on new infectious diseases. A sociologist named Philip Strong. He studied about the new infectious diseases and what are the social ramification or sociology of new infectious diseases. He is making a study based on the 14th century disease, epidemic disease. And he found that there are three important responses. There are three important responses. Three responses. The first response is fear. The second response is moralization. And the third response is action. These are the three responses to any new infectious diseases according to Philip Strong. First is fear. The fear that all are going to die. Nobody is going to survive and everybody is going to die only. Now secondly, they try to identify where the problem lies. They are trying to moralize the disease. How you know? By finding fault with somebody. In the past, the judgment will be epidemic disease is caused by anger of God. So we attribute the reason to divinity. But now this divine justification is replaced by political miscalculation. Divine justification is replaced by political miscalculation. That the state failed to calculate properly and prevent the spread of this new epidemic disease or new infectious disease. So fact, or you make a fault finding now, moralizing. Who is the cause? Earlier God. Today, government. And third is response, action. Third response is action. Something has to be done to prevent the spread of the disease. Something has to be done. So naturally, they try to show some sort of desperation. And this desperation is in the form of isolation of the patients who were infected by this new infectious disease. Isolating them. Socially distancing them. And they raise a slogan, war against China virus. Now the virus is China virus. People fear to buy even Chinese made products, especially children or the parents are fearing to buy for their children Chinese made toys, because somebody says through this Chinese made toys, this coronavirus will come. Chinese restaurants are facing a severe economic crisis because of this coronavirus. And this is nothing but stigmatizing the Chinese people or not. If you come from a Mongolian race, you are suspected today that you may be a causating agent. You may be an agent to spread the deadly disease. Now, everybody, international organizations like World Health Organizations or the national governments have declared a war against coronavirus. War. As if coronavirus is a terrorist, global terrorist, and we have to wage a war against terrorism. In the same fashion, they try to use militaristic approach to fight against the deadly disease. Right? So these are the three responses. And what is happening? Today, they are stigmatizing the Chinese foods or the food behavior of Chinese people. That you eat varieties of animal species, and that is the reason for you spreading this killer disease. So the Chinese food culture is ostracized today. It is criticized today. And the Chinese people have a long tradition of eating varieties of species of animals. From snake to cockroach. They have the habit of eating varieties of animal species. It is a very long food culture which they are practicing without any issue. But now their food culture is seen as the causing agent of the epidemic disease or the main reason for the spread of the epidemic disease. Now the European world is criticizing the Chinese foods. Because from the beginning, European world is not accepting the Chinese food. And they are waiting for the time to come. The time has come and they are finding all fault with the food consumption behavior of the Chinese people. This coronavirus is causing mild damage, or it is causing mild infection to most of the people. The infection is very mild infection to most of the people. And some people it has an intensive infection. Yeah, potentially it is more threatening infection, and only in few cases it has become fatal. So it's like any other disease. For example, there was a disease, influenza, which was spreading in 1918, which caused millions of people to die. 1918, influenza disease caused lakhs of people to die. But when you compare this influenza with that of the coronavirus fatality is very, very less. But how media is projecting this disease, how those who are victims of these diseases are ostracized, socially excluded, racially prejudiced. Those people who are coming from mainland China, they are not given any accommodation in the hotels, or they are not given accommodation in the restaurants because of the fear that they may cause the spread of the disease. So, we try to moralize the food practices of the people. We try to exclude those people who are affected by this disease. And now this is a very big opportunity available for the opponent parties in the China to criticize the government and its nature of authoritarian setup. So, political parties are trying to politicize the epidemic disease, and they are trying to gain political mileage in the spread of the coronavirus. And what the government now does, it declared a war against the China virus. And what they are doing now, they have kickstarted border health checkups. And it is found that border health checkup can only identify 20% of the potential victims of the disease. And there is an insistence to wear face mask. The virus is so small that it will permeate through the face mask. So the approach is, do something. When you do something, what is happening? It is causing depression in the economy. The action of the state or civil society, including media, resulted in the cost of the actions becoming more than the benefits of the action. So we see that we are reducing the economic activities because of the disease, epidemic disease. Disruption is caused to the economic activity. The supply of food and the supply of medicine is getting disrupted because of the actions taken by the state. And this is adding more problem than to solve. So it is depressing the economy. It is cutting off the important supply of food and medicines. The actions taken by the state is causing more negatives than positives. We assume that the world in which we are living is very, very ordered world. It is subjected to so much of stability. And we trust that this order will continue for all times. We believe that today is like yesterday and tomorrow will be like today. This is a very, very erroneous understanding about the world in which we are living. Because constantly the world is evolving. Constantly the society is in a state of dynamics. As Parsons would say, that society is a story of moving equilibrium. There is always threat to the order of the social stability. He writes about order is not Hobbesian order. Order is only workable order. So social evolution is not understood properly. What is happening? A virus is going for genetic mutation. The virus is going for mutation. And it becomes bigger. But the order of natural selection would ensure that when the virus is killing the host and it is spreading from one species to another species, that virus will be stopped. The proliferation of the virus will be stopped by the process of natural selection. So nature is having an order which ensures that the virus is not spreading from one species to another species. At one point of time, natural selection will inhibit such transfer or such migration of the pathogen from one species to another species. So what is happening in the order of nature? Nature allows proliferation of virus. It allows the virus to transmit from one species to another species because of the mutation. But at the same time, the mutation will be stopped by the nature itself through the process of natural selection. What is happening is that we make so much of cry. We make so much of chaos because of the equilibrium which is moving. So how do we understand evolution? When you use a military jargon that we are waging a war against the epidemic disease or China virus, what you try to imagine is, you imagine and you give an illusion that the order of evolution can be contained by the humanity or the technology, which can never ever happen. Evolution cannot be stopped by human science and technology. The limitation of biomedical technology has been unfolding because you are not able to come out with a proper vaccine for Ebola virus, MERS, MERS, SARS. And the recent coronavirus. The limitation of biomedical science and technology is telling you that human intervention in the form of technology cannot halt the process of evolution. If you read the societal evolution, human beings, animals and viruses coexisted and co-evolved. Because of the pressure which we are exerting on the habitations, due to increasing population or due to mechanization or industrialization, our interaction with animals have increased. In the past, animals were living in one place, human being was living in another place, the interaction was quite minimal. But in the present, because of industrialization, because we started invading into the forest resource, forest reserves for industrialization, our connection, our interaction with the animal starts intensified. And in the process, animal to man infections have started. So from animal, the virus is spreading to, or the microorganism is spreading to human being. There is so much of misconception about the new infectious diseases or new diseases whenever it happens. For example, AIDS was first seen as a disease which infects only the gay people. It is a gay disease, AIDS. Then science told that it is not like that. So our understanding of new infectious diseases have been guided by the already present stereotypes. And this itself is causing so much of panicky amongst the people. The human society survived despite of repeated tsunamis, despite of repeated earthquakes, tornadoes, cyclones. It existed, it survived. And we somehow learned how to predict it. We somehow learned how to predict the natural disasters. So the disaster management system is put in place in most of the developing countries, including the, because of the assistance of the international institutions. Sustainable Development Goal speaks about this. But the new infection comes out of the blue. And therefore, it is militating against any futuristic management plans. So the reason is nothing but a natural course of evolution. Epidemic, pandemic should not be leading to chaos, because we should understand that there is some degree of uncontrollability which humanity has with respect to epidemic disease. There are some degrees of uncontrollability. Even now for AIDS, you don't have a proper medicine. Ebola virus caused so much of confusion, pandemonium in the society. World Health Organization wanted thousands of dollars for finding a medicine for Ebola disease. So, we have to understand this, that science and technology is having its own limitation. In the process of evolution, we have to encounter these problems. What Ivan Illich says, Ivan Illich, he writes about de-schooling system. He is very famous for his concept of de-schooling. In 1970s, he found that modern societies are having certain problems in the form of medical hubris. Modern technology or modern society assumes that we can bend the nature to our advantage using technology. In the process, we forgot to live a harmonious life with the nature. So technology gave a belief to the modern man that he can tackle any problem using his rational mind and the forces of science and technology. Because of this intellectual arrogance, man lost how to lead a harmonious life with the nature. Earlier there was man-nature harmony existing, so man adapted to the changing order of the nature. Man successfully adapted to the changing order of nature, but today man believes that his modern mind can give him science and technology. With that he will be able to conquer the entire nature, and in this mindset he lost how to lead a harmonious life with the forces of nature. The result is today man is living in a state of insecurity. Ulrich Beck writes about risk society. He writes about risk society. There are a number of pandemics, epidemics for which the cure is not known because the cause is not known. We do not know the cause, and therefore we are not able to find out solution for that. So Ivan Illich therefore says that there are many medical emergencies which modern society faces, which cannot be avoided. Just because it cannot be avoided, that medical emergencies cannot be avoided, or new infectious diseases cannot be avoided, doesn't mean that we should not try to manage it. We should leave it. It is not meaning that. It means that you should understand the limitations of human rationality. So we have seen that the medical world is unable to tell whether coronavirus will be as deadly as SARS or it will be like a seasonal disease. Whether coronavirus will be as deadly as SARS or it will be like a seasonal disease, the medical world is not able to tell in clear-cut terms. And this has added insecurity to us. So, what should we do now? We should not damage the social and economic life because of stereotypes we have with the or about the new disease. We should not damage the social or economic life because of the stereotype we have about the new infectious disease. We should accept that when the new infectious disease attacks many, many have the capacity to develop antibodies. Nature also has gifted human being the possibility of development of antibodies when you are hit by a disease. So there is a need for belief that antibodies will be developed and it gives some sort of immunity to persons against the new infectious disease. And by that time, science and technology will come out with some management plans, medicines or therapies. What we find is there is a prejudice associated with the disease. For example, a disease is, academia is linking disease with places. Ebola virus is linked to a river in Congo. Ebola virus is related to Congo. MERS, MERS is related to Arabian Peninsula. And this recent coronavirus is associated to Wuhan city. So we are associating names with the disease. The result is those people coming from these places are subjected to exclusion, social distancing. When you do the social distancing of people based on places, based on race, based on ethnicity, then those who have symptoms of the new infections may refuse to come out and seek medical treatment because you are prejudicing them. So a person from Wuhan will say that I don't have the symptom at all. Even though he catches the symptom, he will refuse to openly say that he had the symptom because of the presence of isolation. Some people who were suspected to have coronavirus, they were stopped in the middle of the sea. We found that some Indians were there in the ship who could not come to the country because the government has taken a clear stand that whatever may be the case, we will not let anyone to come from that ship irrespective of their nationality. So there is a fear associated with the spread of the new disease because of this, as you will be stigmatized, you will be prejudiced. As long as you do this social distancing, people don't come to medical treatment. So exclusion, marginalization and social suffocation, along with fear, panic, results in the management of the new infectious disease more difficult. Right? So this is sociology of coronavirus. Thinkers and environment.